SpotHype.com here with Edwin Rodriguez. Edwin, first of all, I want to congratulate you on hooking up with Al Haymon. Tell me how that came about.
Thank you. It was a great move. I recently just ended prior to with my old manager. Al Haymon is the A-team. So he's trying to get the best fights, and that's what Al Haymon brings to the table.
That seems like a no-brainer to hook up with Al Haymon, right?
Definitely. It was. I mean, I spoke to Al Haymon on the phone, and like you said, it was a no-brainer.
That's what's up. Tell me about, you know, what's next for you. I know there's been some talk about the whole Andre Ward situation and everything. Sounds like that fight's not happening. So, I mean, who do you want to go after next?
You know, honestly, Andre Ward's the best guy in my weight class. He's the man to fight, so that's the fight I want. There's some business things going behind the doors who Al Haymon, you know, take care of. You know, I personally want that fight with Andre Ward. You know, he went on board to say that $800,000 is the most I ever made, whatever. Homie, you tell people not to make comments about how much money you make. Well, if you're making over $1 million enough to fight me, don't comment how much I make. So that's that. And I'm here, so you know, if the money's right, let's do it.
There was some talk, I mean, about that whole Andre Ward situation. There was some talk that HBO was, you know, trying to force that fight, this, that, and the other, before you had got with Al Haymon. But then when you got with Al Haymon, it seemed like things kind of fizzled a little bit. Was that the case? Is that how it went down? Or
you know, I met up with HBO and my promoter, Lou DiBella. It was a fight that was brought up for me to fight Andre Ward on September 28th. I fought in July in Monte Carlo. There wasn't enough time for me. I had some plans with my family, and there wasn't enough time for me to take that fight on September 28th. So that was off the board for me. After I signed with him, and then it came up the day of November. But like I said, I'm still willing to take the fight, because Andre Ward is the best fighter in my weight class, and that's the only way to prove who the man is. So, you know, that's the fight I want.
Is that fight still a possibility? Like, are there still negotiations going on behind the scenes, or is that pretty much dead in the water?
You know, it's a little dead in the water, but if it doesn't happen now, it'll definitely happen later on. I won that fight, so make happen.
Even if that doesn't happen, obviously, you know, Al Haymon has some other fighters out there that you can fight. He has another champion, Saki Obika. Is that kind of the direction you think you'll be heading in?
Definitely, you know, he has good working relationship with the Showtime. So I know Saki Obika won the WBC not too long ago, and that's a fight that we're looking to get for a world title. I know he has a mandatory coming up, I believe, with Anthony Durrell. I'm not sure how that's going, if that's happening or what, but, you know, I won the winner.
Do you have an expected return date? I mean, obviously you said, you know, the September date wasn't going to work for you. Are you looking to get another fight in this year, or is it going to be pushed back?
Definitely. I won one fight this year. I'm going to be talking to Haymon about it. You know, I know everything has been hectic with Mayweather, so after the Mayweather fight, we'll sit down and talk about what's next, who's moving on forward. More fights happening, or if not gonna happen, and if it's not, then you know, I want to fight one more fight this year, and go for whoever wins between Saki Obika and Anthony Durrell.
When you look at the fighters in your division, I mean, you know, there's a few names out there, but do you consider the division as, you know, as far as big names? I mean, obviously there's Andre Ward, obviously, you know, there's Carl Froch floating out there, but outside of that, I mean, how many other big names are out there for you? I mean, do you see yourself staying at 168 for a long time, or do you think you have to make a move?
I do see myself staying at 168, although I wouldn't be opposed to moving up to fight at 75 either. But, you know, there's a lot of big names in my weight class. There's Mikel Kessler, Arthur Abraham Ward, Lucien Bute, who are a good step up and good fight for me, fan-friendly wise. And, you know, there's still a lot of big names there for me to conquer.
That's what's up. Give me your thoughts on, obviously, I'm sure you're going to be here checking out the fights on Saturday. Give me your thoughts on you know, the two big fights. I mean, who do you like in Garcia Matisse first?
I want my boy Danny Garcia. I think that he's going to stop Matisse, who happened to be a really, really good fighter who I like as well. But I think that Danny's power is underrated, and I think he'll be able to get the job done. And Mayweather, he's just Mayweather. He's just untouchable. You know, I do give Canelo some credit. He's a very good fighter. I think he's the best fighter in boxing right now. So this is an exciting place to be at. I'm a fan. I'm just looking forward to seeing Mayweather perform, and I just see a good fight.
Let me ask you one more quick question, just because Angel Garcia brought it up in there, and you know, you being an American fighter, you know, Angel kind of feels like American fighters don't get the kind of respect that they deserve, and I was just curious if you felt like that, just because you're in a division that has a lot of European fighters who, you know, are getting a lot of attention.
I don't feel like that at all. I mean, you know, I came from Dominican Republic, and you know, U.S.-based fighter, and I have gotten a lot of love and respect. Respect is earned, you know, I gotta continue to earn it. And I do believe that Danny has gotten a lot of respect, and I mean, he has accomplished a lot of things in boxing. Maybe his father feels like he deserves more, but you know, I think that I have gotten the respect, and respect is earned, so I just gotta go out there and earn it.
Let your actions speak.
Yeah.
That's what's up, man. Appreciate it. All right.